llegado a caer aquí contigo
entre tus brazos de seda, amor.
Qué bonito es encontrarte al fin
después de tanto tiempo solo. ¿Cómo es que todo se ve mejor contigo?
¿Cómo es que nada parece igual?
No puede ser, amor, lo que siento en mí es mucho más de lo que imaginaba.
En un momento el corazón perdí, sin darme cuenta todo te lo di, y en mi pecho siento nueva vida donde mi corazón siento presa de ti
y no me quiero escapar
de tu vida. Oh, oh, tú llenaste mi corazón con tu querer, con tu alma y tu ser. No te quiero perder nunca, nunca. En un momento has cambiado todo, amigo.
Lo que esperaba al fin llegó.
Lo que nadie más pude encontrar
sin esperar cae en mis manos.
Oh, oh.
¿Cómo es que todo se ve mejor contigo?
¿Cómo es que nada parece igual?
No puede ser, amor, lo que siento en mí es mucho más de lo que imaginaba.
Donde mi corazón dormía. Tú robaste mi corazón. ¿Qué puedo hacer? Me siento presa de ti
y no me quiero escapar
de tu vida. Quiero perder nunca, nunca. Tú robaste mi corazón. ¿Qué puedo hacer? Me siento presa de ti.
Quiero escapar
de tu vida.
De tu vida.
No. Tú llenaste mi corazón con tu querer,
con tu alma y tu ser.
No te quiero perder nunca, nunca.
Como un niño.
cómo te extraño.
Le gusta bailar cumbia, porque le gusta.
gusta bailar cumbia, porque le gusta bailar cumbia, porque le gusta ya bailar, porque le gusta bailar cumbia, porque le gusta bailar cumbia, porque le gusta bailar cumbia, porque le gusta ya bailar.
Adiós, y rompió con tus planes. Yo sé que es un golpe duro al corazón y tu mundo se parte. Son las cosas que tiene el amor: ganar o perder. Estas son las reglas del juego. Soledad, no te encierres con llaves. En cualquier lugar te encuentras con otro amor y te cambia hasta el aire. Es a todo o nada, ya ves. Ganar o perder, estas son las reglas del juego.
Amores, ahí viene mi piquito de Le gusta que la abrace y que le diga mi lindo tesoro. Ahí viene mi piquito de oro. Ahí viene a darme sus amores. Ahí viene mi piquito de oro. Ahí viene mi lindo tesoro.
Cortada antes del abrir, una vida larga robada antes de vivir, fue como paloma que no alcanzó a volar. Ah, era aquella luz que alumbró el camino de nuestra música. Es ella como el día que no pudo amanecer. Es ella como niña y apenas fue mujer.
Es como una estrella que siempre brillará.
De aquella luz que alumbró el camino de nuestra música.
Vivirás, vivirás, vivirás.
Vivirás siempre, Selina.
Vivirás, vivirás.
Que sea como niña y apenas fue mujer. Es como una estrella que siempre brillará. Era aquella luz que alumbró el camino de nuestra música.
Nunca. que tenga un toque especial, que sea como es, un aspecto tan normal que a veces ni la ves, que no sea un huracán y que nunca eclipse el sol, un aroma familiar que sea casi miel, que sea tanto amor, yo lo escribo en un cartel. Un hombre busca una mujer, esa flor desconocida, que va como loca por la vida. Es simplemente diferente, si tú la ves más que amigo, como hermano. Ven, entrégamela en la mano. Yo soy un hombre y busco una. Amor de juventud, sin trucos al hablar, brilla bello con la luz y con la oscuridad. Y no es la luna, no es el sol, ni campo ni ciudad. Ella se llama porque sí, porque ese es su papel. La casi casi abril, yo lo escribo en un cartel. Un hombre busca una mujer, esa flor desconocida, como loca por la vida. Es simplemente diferente, si tú la ves más que amigo, como hermano. Ven, entrégamela en la mano. Yo soy un hombre y busco una mujer, esa flor desconocida, que va como loca por la vida. Es simplemente diferente, si tú la ves más que amigo, como hermano. Ven, entrégamela en la mano. Yo soy un hombre y busco una
As far as the live concert was concerned, nobody came back in. What the fans are getting on that CD is 100% what was recorded that day. We didn't come in. We didn't touch anything up. All we did was just mix it, digitally mix it again. But as far as the Dinos coming in and redoing parts, none of us came back in to record. That stayed 100% the way it was recorded that day. Yeah, I think it represents us. I listened to the album, and sometimes it's like surreal, I guess, because I was, you know, with her there and part of all that. But looking back now and listening to the CDs, I go, man, we had a really hot band, man. We had a really hot band. Selena was a hot singer, you know, and sometimes to me it's surreal for me, and I can't even begin to explain what an honor it was for me to be a Dino.
The last concert was the audio from the live concert that Selena done at the Astrodome in 95, about a month before her passing. It was recorded at the time during the performance, and because of the acoustics at the Astrodome, we had to really, really do a lot of work to clean up the audio. I think that our engineer, Brian Moore, done an excellent job in cleaning some of it up and making it sound good. So we released it, and it was very successful. It was on the Billboard charts for quite a few months. One thing that I do remember is that on the Selena movie soundtrack, we took the audio from the live concert, and we changed everything around. We brought in the musicians to do their parts here in the studio. But on the last concert, we didn't do that. Every instrument that you hear in there was the band playing live. And so there is a difference in the soundtrack and the last concert. The last concert, it really shows the musical ability of the group, how they would ad-lib. You know, they were spontaneous. how tight the band was. And, of course, you can see Selena, the performer that she was. She was very energetic. One thing that really, really amazed me was that she could be spinning and turning and dancing, everything, and she would be in tune and keep the timing. You know, it's that's pretty hard to do. If anybody is a singer, they know how hard that is to, you know, to be singing and moving and jumping and keeping the timing and the being in tune and not get, you know, where you're breathing hard. She was an amazing performer.
The last concert, you know, I was not a part of this concert. I was sick. I had broken my ankle and I wasn't able to perform. And after everything happened and Selena, you know, left us, it really bothered me that I was not there for that one particular concert for many months. And then just one day I just woke up and decided, you know what, I had 17 years of being right there with her and watching her perform and being right behind her. You know, I just kind of forgot about how I felt, you know, on that last concert. A lot of people asked me, why weren't you there? And I was just sick. I wasn't able to be there. But I think that the concert came out incredible. I think that Jay, which is the drummer who sat in for me, did an awesome job and the band sounded great. Now that I look back and see the footage of it, it was an incredible concert. And I think that this album, if you listen to it, it puts you right there and you feel it. You know, you close your eyes and you can envision her and the whole band performing.
Selena, the last concert CD, the live one, which is actually a real live album. A lot of people or a lot of groups, you know, they go in. And I mean, we've done it before too, where you go into the studio after you record, say, a live show, and there's a mistake, say, speaking on my part, say there's a guitar chord that maybe I didn't play as clean as I could have, or maybe I just hit the wrong chord altogether, you know, for that one split second. So what you would do is, you know, go into the studio and repair it, or what have you, you know, fix the things up that maybe you could have done better. This one, live, the last concert that was recorded in Houston at the Stock Show and Rodeo, is as live as it gets. I'm sure people or the fans would appreciate the fact that they're getting the real deal. You know, I mean, this is what we sounded like live. You know, you can hear all the fun that we were having on stage. And the memories I have of that show, I mean, there are many of them, but I remember the, you know, seeing all those people there. I mean, thousands upon thousands of people. To see all them there, you know, supporting the band, Selena. I remember standing up there looking around and just, I don't know how, you know, how much people could see it, but man, I had this lump in my throat that was, I mean, it, you know, hard to swallow. I mean, all these things come back into play about how successful the band was and how much love that she was getting from the crowd, you know, during the course of the show. All those things, I mean, were just, it was surreal in a way, like almost like it wasn't happening, you know, and the place was just so huge and the audience was not up on the stage like we were so used to doing, you know, but you could hear them and you couldn't really see them once we started when the lights had gone down, you know. It was just a weird moment in time for me and it's something that I'll never, never forget. You know, I hear it now, that live show, and just appreciate everything more, you know, AB's, you know, being up on stage and taking control of the situation and calling out the songs and keeping everybody, you know, together. You know, it's a hard thing to do. And, you know, that having the team that we were, you know, with Rick and Joe and Art, you know, and Selena, of course, and AB. And I mean, just, you know, feeling like part of a winning team, you know, I mean, that comes across on the recording to me, you know, and I'm sure a lot of the people that weren't there, you know, well, hopefully they'll get that feeling as well, because that's pretty much what you're listening to. You know, that's what's going on up on that stage. My favorite part of the live show was the beginning of it, because, you know, we're holding down this one note and I get to do some little feedback things on the guitar, which, you know, in Tejano music is not very common. You know, and not that we were going to open with a Tejano song, but to come out with that heaviness, you know, it felt really good for me as a guitar player. And then to go into these, you know, pop tunes and have them mixed up the way that AB does it, you know, I mean, just kind of rearranging them and adding, you know, the modern touch to it that they had. It was just, for me, it was a lot of fun to play those beginning songs. And, you know, it's the first song of the show. And, I mean, it's like just this pressure that, you know, is boiling, you know, and it just all kind of just comes out on that first song with the fans and the band and just the energy that's going around that place, you know. You can pick it up on the CD. You can hear it. Yeah, that disco medley was something really new to us. So, I mean, it felt fresh, you know. It wasn't something that we had played 100 times before, you know. That's one of the things about Los Dinos that a lot of people don't realize that I've talked to, is that we hardly practiced together, you know. I mean, if we were together in a room, if I was in a room with AB and Rick, you know, it was to be there while the music was being actually composed and arranged, and, you know, be there for that part of it. But man, I mean, there was probably about, I don't know, maybe we probably practiced once or twice as a group together in a room. I mean, we played so much live, and it was almost like, we could predict what was coming next. You know what I mean? What we were going to do, when really it was always changing up, because maybe we'd never played the same set list. So, you know, I mean, this disco medley for us was a new thing, and Selena just totally took it, and you know, she sang it incredibly well and made it her own.
This concert was actually the third year in a row that we had done the concert, so we pretty much knew, you know, what was going to happen. You know, you're going to wait here, and then they'll take you out in the little golf cart, and blah, 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 blah. They'll turn down the lights. The oddest part about playing this concert is that they turn off the lights, and you can't really see the people because they're so far away. So it's kind of hard to get into it. And then add on top of that, it's a huge, I mean, it's the Astrodome, it's huge. So it takes your brain a couple of seconds, well, maybe a little more than a couple of seconds, to get used to the bounce back of the music. Because when you start playing, it bounces back, and it's not in time, and you're like, you know, and I have no rhythm to begin with. So for me, it's particularly hard. But you get used to it after a while. I like doing the disco medley. We had learned it not long before this concert. And I grew up in the time of the back in the 70s and 80s, so you know, it was fun playing those songs, and even though you couldn't see the crowd, you know, you could hear them. I mean, they made a lot of noise. And I was always amazed that for just 45 minutes or 50 minutes they were up there. I mean, so many people would show up. I always thought that was, I mean, it was over, I guess, from what I hear, over 60,000, 65,000, 66,000 people. And I thought that was pretty cool. On that show, nothing really went wrong. One of the roadies got trapped, and he spent the whole concert behind one of the speakers because they wouldn't let him out. They told him to stay there because of the cameras, and you would just be in the way, and so he got stuck. But as far as playing-wise, I mean, I think everything went pretty cool. No, there were no... I don't think there were any equipment failures, which is something, I mean, I guess every musician, when you're playing, you know, you don't think about it, but when it, you know, but it's there. But no, this one ran pretty smooth. I think that on this concert, it was a little bit different, you know, for Selena, because she had been, you have to remember, this was around the time that she was recording the other album, the Dreaming of You album. You know, she was recording songs, so she'd been singing a lot of English. She'd been doing, you know, she'd been visiting with a lot of different producers, and so she'd been hearing a lot of different things. So, and this one, she, you know, you could tell that she, you know, there was more improvising on her part as far as singing, and just overall, for some reason, I think this concert, she just looked so relaxed, and she was so. Professional. I don't know what the word is, but she wailed. She jammed. I think she really did good on this particular concert. And when you see it on video, you can just tell. She understood that they were, you know, that she was there to entertain, and she just turned it on. She was in command. She was in control.
Para los fanáticos de Selena, los Dinos. esto que se está haciendo de 20 años de música de Serino Los Dinos es algo que es una labor de amor. Lo estamos haciendo para todos los fans, los fanáticos de Selena, para todos los coleccionistas, y los invitamos que lo escuchen.